everybody, it's Single here, and today I am back at you with another video because I'm getting married this week. I don't even know. It is so crazy that it is wedding week. Like, what? I don't know, I'm speechless. So I thought this week would be an excellent week, now that the wedding is just around the corner, to share with you all if I could pick three top things that I could give advice on for anyone else who's diving into the wedding planning process or is stressed about the wedding planning process or anything like that. I wanted to share my top three with you all. Before we get into it, if you are new here, do not forget to subscribe on your way out if you like videos like this. Without further ado, let's get into it. So I'm not gonna go into the nitty-gritty details of wedding planning. If you are looking for a video like that, click away from this one. I'm gonna go with the total overarching aspects of wedding planning that I would advise people to pay attention to as their wedding planning. These will not apply to everyone, so keep that in mind. I understand that, but this is just what I would tell my past self when diving into wedding planning, just some advice. Number one, do not rush. The moment you get engaged, I have seen people want to have their wedding straight away. And now I'm not talking about people, you know, with religious backgrounds and they want to, you know, live with their spouse or they're moving away, or anyone with, you know, a visa, if someone's from another country. I'm not talking about those or anything like that. So that's not who this applies to, and I totally understand that. But if you're anything like me and you get engaged and your head first goes into, how close can I have the wedding? Don't rush into it. You're engaged, enjoy it. It is so much fun. And the thing is that you have the rest of your lives to be married. So the more time you give yourself, the more you can enjoy the engagement, the more you can draw out the excitement, and also the more time that you'll have for wedding planning. And one, that's awesome because wedding planning can be really fun if it's not super rushed all the time or anything like that. But two, everything on your day will be perfect. It will be awesome. So number one, don't rush. Number two, I would say, is trust the experts. And when I say experts, I mean everything from your florist to your baker to your seamstress who's hemming your dress or altering your dress. Just trust them. They have done this more times than you have, unless you've been married like 20,000 times or something like that. But they have done this so many times. They won't necessarily offer their opinions on things unless you ask about them, because they do want to be respectful of your wishes. They'll step in and advise if you're going like the completely wrong path. But generally, if it's like an opinion thing, they're not gonna step in. So if you're wondering if I should go this route on the flowers, or will this work, or what should be the situation here, ask. I would ask my seamstress. Did you guys know that there's two ways to do a dress bustle? Like if you have a train on your dress, you can like tie it behind your back or something like that. I had no idea, and I was stuck in between which one I wanted. So she didn't give her opinion, but when I asked her, she was like, I don't like to give my opinion, but I really like this way. And I was like, okay, phew. Like, I was leaning towards that way anyway. So she's just, they've seen it all, and they've seen things done not wrong. You can't really do things wrong, but they've seen things done not so well, and they've seen things done well, and it goes really well for the bride. So number two, trust your experts. And then my third thing that I would go back and tell myself right before everything, and just it could save me a lot of time actually, is don't be trendy. And when I say that, I mean there are going to be wedding trends every single year. There are going to be the mason jars and the barn and the hay and the boots, and that was a trend, you know, a couple years ago. There are going to be, you know, special flower prints for invitations. There's going to be special fonts that are in now, but the thing is, all of those things could be in now and out tomorrow, and your wedding pictures are going to last forever. So when you're choosing things like that, I totally understand because I get wrapped up in all of the trends, you know, for Instagram and for, you know, the special pictures and the invitations, and I just get wrapped up in all in it. But I continuously had to stop myself and say, you know, if I was looking at this picture 20 years from now, would I still like that color? You know, if I was looking at this picture 20 years from now, would this dress still be classic? But if you find yourself loving a trend, you know, loving a font, loving a flower, loving a, you know, special thing, and you can't get your mind off of it, go for it. Like, classics don't happen just by themselves. You know, some trends do stick. And if you love that flower or that font or that color or anything like that, go for it. It's just, there were times where I would look at, you know, this specific flower print that's super in right now, and I love it, but I know that it's gonna be out 2 months from now. I just had to step back in those moments and think, this is my wedding, this is my marriage, it's gonna last forever, and I just wanna look back and have everything still be perfect. I know this was a quick video for you guys. I just wanted to share my top 3 wedding tips that I would give anybody who's diving into planning a wedding right now. I can't believe my wedding's this weekend. I don't even know. I'm so over the moon and so excited. Oh my gosh. There will be a wedding video. We are having videographers there for the wedding, so that will hopefully be one of my next videos soon, depending on how long they can match everything together and all of that stuff. But that I cannot wait to share with you all. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big old thumbs up. It lets me know that you liked it. And if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe on your way out. It just takes one little click of that red button down there. And I will catch you guys next time. See you later.